Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Sometime while working on JIT, you receive a similar error like this when you try to execute the git commands in your terminal or in the command prompt or whatever. You receive a similar error like this one. How do you solve this? If you are facing the same issue or a similar issue, then this video tutorial is good for you. Without further ado, let's go. Then what we have to do here is, first, I'm having this problem here. If I can describe it here, I have my VL Studio here, and I wanted to pull, download some code, clone some codes from repository, and I try to run Git, and I receive this one. So Git is not recognized in a terminal. So the same thing is also going here in the command prompt. You can see that here Git is not recognized as internal comments. So in order to solve this one, we have to install Git in our computer, right? And if you have already installed it, then you can forward go to at the end of this video to see how you can add it in the path. But before that, let's download Git. We agree here, we go here to download, and here we click on Windows. Our computers in Windows, and then it will automatically download Git for us, depending if you are running 34 or 32 or 64 bit. Then it will automatically detect it and download it for us. Here we are running a 64 bit, then that's why we have this one. So we right click, go to properties, then unlock it, make it secure to run in our computer. Then now we run it as admin. We start the installations now. Next, we go to next. Here is where you want to install it. Take care of this directory. We'll come back to that later. Then here it already exists. I've installed another one before, so install it anyway. Then here we can just move with the default. Here default, here default, here default. We go with only default here. So you may customize it, but if you are new, it's just better to just go with the default settings. Installing, you just take few minutes, few seconds. Then now after the installation is completed, then we have something like this one, and we may also select this one, finish, start. Here we have our terminal. This terminal is there, but what if you go here and execute, nothing is not yet recognized. So the next thing after this one is finished here is to click, just close that and go now to our repository where we installed it. Remember, we installed it here in program C program file, and we have it under C program file git. Then we are going to take this bin and comment here, right? So here we take bin, we go to our environment, we click here environment. And then here we go to environment variables. Under environment variable, here we select the path, we edit the path. Here you are going to add a new value. You add the bin. And we go again downstairs. We also need to add this command. And you can see that by selecting automatically it's even already added by Windows 10. If not, you could just go again here and paste it. Then we click OK. OK. OK here. And then we are going to close this command prompt. Then go against there, then right click, open it as now if we type git v now, we can see that it's recognized now. Okay, then now, yeah, it's good to go. Then if we try again with we type again git here. It's not yet. We are going to close this one and open again VS Code. We are going here to a terminal. We try to go to a path right here. So we write git now. Yeah, bam, it is recognized now. Now that is it. Right now you can go now and take anything that you want and yeah, and download it. You can now execute any git commands or clone whatever you want from the repository. So I hope that this video tutorial has been useful to you, and from now you will move up with your projects. So if you like it, press the like button. If you have any objections, do not hesitate to drop a comment and subscribe to the channel in order not to miss the next sessions. Stay tuned. Bye.